I know that the team behind Dark Matter is really trying to move away from qualifying characters and their strength by their gender and saying that that sets them apart, that sets their strength apart and makes it extra special because of their gender. And in fact, it's just another strong character that's stepping up to the plate and is the best option for that role. And by role, I mean the position in the ship, in the context of the story. Like Six, Two is also level-headed for the most part, unless she's put in a do-or-die type of situation. Mm-hmm. And they're kind of the parental figures. And together they figure out what's the best move at all times. I think on our show we've not sexualized the main female characters on our show. Not that that's not a part of everyday life, because it is, but I do think that the market in that genre, especially on television. Yeah, it's not exactly.
It's in there as a
cop, that's real.
Yeah, exactly, but we're not.
They have more substance than that. It's not just about that.
Not that sexuality isn't substance either. It's like that is a part of human nature, but we're not heavily featuring it in a way that sensationalizes it and makes it something that is the focal point and the main thing that she brings to the table, which, circling back, I think is important for us to see representations of on television, so that, you know, young women can see that that's not the only thing that we need to bring to the table in order to be seen and heard and
matter.
Yeah, and matter. I think that everybody's doing what they feel is right for them in that moment, and whether or not that's good or bad is obviously based on the lens, whoever's looking at that, right? But I think a lot of people, for the most part, that's the fun. It's like the greatest exercise in empathy is to get into the shoes of whoever this bad person is or whoever this good person is, and trying to make whatever decision that they're making in that moment be completely rational. This is the right choice to make in this exact moment. And it doesn't matter if I'm good or bad. That's none of my business. Is this what I need to do right now? Because what do I want? Can we tell you guys about season two? Mm-hmm. Well, first of all, we air July 1st. Yeah. July 1st.
July 4th over here.
July 4th. Is it July 4th over
July
here?
4th
okay. Good to know. Good to know.
July 1st or July 4th. It's one of those 4 days. Please look for
watch
it.
Watch TV every day for 4 days. Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. What can we tell them? We start off in Galactic Prison. And
it gets darker. It's definitely darker.
It's a very dark season. And we do a lot more adventures splitting off from each other. I think
we have a lot of adventures this season. Yeah.
Last year we were doing a lot of ship-based ensemble pieces, and this year we're really branching off and going off onto our own adventures. Sometimes it felt like we didn't even work together.
I know.
I'm like, right, how have you been?
I wouldn't see you for ages.
I know.
Yeah. I'm so looking forward to seeing everything that's happening, because the scripts were great. And
really dynamic, they really
exciting, fast-paced. Yeah. A lot of action and drama. Mm-hmm. The other day, my agent said that he was trying to find out from a person, a casting director, you know, when are you going to have Melissa reoccur on this next season? And he was telling me this story, and he was just like, and the casting director said, I'm sorry, who are you talking about? And I think that I told my agent, like, please don't ever keep stories like that away from me. Like, I always want to hear about shit like that, because I think it's important to have humility and to remember that, like, yeah, sure, some people know you in one realm, but really the world is so big and you're an ant, and it's important to remember that. So I hope to have many more experiences like that. It keeps me humble.